So happy Diwali everyone. I hope this Diwali brings lots of joy and prosperity to each and every one of you. And I hope you will be and we will all be able to hug our loved ones very soon without fear of infecting them with a virus. All right, that being said, welcome to another video on object-oriented programming with C++. Up to this point, we have been talking a lot about access modifiers, also called access specifiers. So we saw two of them, public and protected. Sorry, public and private. In this video, we are going to look at the third type of access modifier. It is called protected. Okay, so without further ado, let us write a small program and see for ourselves. So I'm going to, as always, start with including IOStream. Then I am going to have this using namespace std. Then let me go ahead and create a class. Let me call it base. And this is going to have several data attributes. All right, first is going to be private, and let me call it int mPrivate. Then I'm going to have public. Let me call it int mPublic. Okay, and so yeah, this is my class, and let me write a main function. This is going to here I'm going to create an object of base class. Okay, and let me try to access this m public. Okay, and write set it to 10, and then let me print out the value of m public. So I am writing b dot m public. This is an object and not a pointer to an object. Had this been a pointer to an object, I would have written b arrow m public, right? We use arrow operator in case we access these methods and data attributes using a pointer. But here I am not using a pointer. Here I am using the object directly, object name directly. So I write dot instead of arrow. All right, so this is my program. I am going to return 0 because int returns, this main is returning an int. So let me go ahead and compile this program. Yeah, everything is working fine. Good. Now, instead of m public, if I write m private, this would be an error, right? So I cannot access the private data attribute outside the class, right? So let me try to compile this, and yes, I get an error. Private is private within this context. So I cannot access mPrivate. Sorry. I cannot access mPrivate. All right. Fine. So nothing new till now. Okay, we have talked about all these things before. So there is nothing new that you have learned till now. So let us learn something new. I'm going to create one more data attribute, and this is going to be protected. Okay. And let me, I cannot access mPrivate, that's fine. I know that already. Let me try to access mProtected. Okay, go ahead and compile. Okay, m protected is protected within this context, so I cannot access m protected as well outside my class. So what's the deal? I cannot access private attributes, I cannot access protected attribute, I can access public, so I cannot access both protected and private in my main function. Right, then what is the use of having these two different things? What is the use of having private and protected? Why not simply have one of them? Why not simply have private? Okay, if protect is also not accessible, private is definitely not accessible outside my class, then why have two different things, right? So that is a question. So there is a reason why we have mProtected. All right, the thing is that this mProtected makes sense when used in the context of inheritance, when used in inheritance. So let us go ahead and do this inheritance. Let me create another class called derived. Okay, and I am going to inherit with public, okay, from base. So this is public inheritance. All right, I am using this keyword public in front of the parent class name. All right, so I have this derived, this is the derived class, and this is the base class. This is the derived is a child class and base is the parent class. So in case of parent class name, I am writing this access modifier public. Okay, now here is the question. What are the attributes of the base class that I can access in my derived class? Right. For example, let us say I have two functions in my derived class. One is setValue, and this is going to take some integer x, and it is going to set the value. It is going to set say m public to x. Okay, and I have another function int getValue, and this is not going to take any parameter, but it is going to return the value of m public. Fine. Okay. Now there is one more problem. This setValue and getValue, this function I cannot access over here in my main. Why? Because by default everything is private. So I did not write any access modifier, so both of these would be private. Okay, let me try to do this. Instead of base class, I am going to create an object of derived class. Okay, so let me call this D, and then let me create an object. Let me call this setValue with 10, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the value and print it. Alright, so this is what I have. Let me go ahead and compile this. Okay, this should be derived. Okay, so I cannot access getValue. I can neither access setValue. Okay, setValue and getValue, both of them are private. So these two methods, let me make them public. I want to access them outside the class. Okay, I want to access them in main function. So let me go ahead and make them public. Done. Now I can compile this program, and yes, I am setting in line number 22, I am setting the value of, I am calling this setValue function with parameter 10, and then this setValue function is setting the value of mPublic to the parameter that I have passed, that is 10. Okay, and when I call getValue, I get this value of mPublic, which is 10. So I am printing 10 into my screen. Okay, in line number 22, I am setting 10 to mPublic, and in line number 23, I am printing the value, that is 10 of mPublic. Okay, fine. This is what I have. Now, one thing you should notice is that I am not declaring this mPublic inside my derived class. This mPublic attribute I am inheriting from my base class, right? Okay. Now we have set the value of mPublic and returned the value of mPublic. Let me try to access and set the value of mPrivate. Okay. So let me go ahead and compile, and I cannot access it. Okay. mPrivate is private within this context. So this private data attribute of base class I was unable to access it inside this main function, and I am unable to access it inside this derived class as well. Okay, what is private to the class. I cannot access it outside the class. What about protected? In protected also we had the same problem. We were unable to access it outside the class. In my main function, I was unable to access the protected data attribute, right? I am protected. When I tried to set the value, I got an error. When I tried to access the value, I got an error. So let me now try to work with protected again. Okay, let me go ahead and compile. Okay, now it compiles and executes perfectly. Previously in my main function, I was unable to access the value of this mProtected, but in my derived class, I am able to access the value of mProtected. Okay, so this is what we have. Okay, and through this derived class, let me do one thing. Let me print, or let me set, okay, d dot m public equal to 10, d dot m protected equal to 15. This is what I have. I will comment this out later. These two lines were working fine, so let me comment this out. Okay, let me see if I get an error with this. Yes, I am getting an error. mProtect is protected within this context. So using this derived class also, I cannot access this mProtected. Right? Previously, I created an object of base class. So I had an object like this, base D, and when I compiled it, I was unable to access this mProtected. Using this derived class also, which inherits from base class, I am still unable to access this mProtected outside. This class, right? mProtected, I cannot still access in my main function. So in my main function, I can access mPublic. So mPublic, which is there in my base class, when I create an object of this derived class, I am able to access this mPublic. Okay? When I try to create an object of base class, I am unable to access mProtected and mPrivate. I am only able to access mPublic. Fine. In my main function. But what about inside this derived class? We saw this. We cannot access the private variables anywhere, private data attributes or private methods in my main function, in my derived class, nowhere. Okay, only inside my base class I will be able to access the private data attribute of base class. Okay, nowhere else. Public, I can access it in my main function, I can access it in my derived class, I can access it everywhere. Okay, what about protected? Protected, I cannot access it in my main function. Okay, we saw this, but I can access it in my derived class. Okay, from base I am inheriting in derived class, and in my derived class I am able to access the protected variable, protected data attribute. So I am able to set the value of mProtected. I am able to get the value of mProtected. Okay, I am able to do all this thing with protected data attribute, but I cannot set or get this protected data attribute outside of means base and derived class. So in base and derived class, I can access them. Outside this base and derived class, that is in my main function, for example, I cannot access them, right? So this is protected. Okay, fine. So this is what I have till now. Okay. Now let us do one more trick. Instead of accessing inheriting using this public, okay, let me try to inherit using protected. Okay, once again let me start with public, mpublic. I'm going to set the value of mpublic and I'm going to return the value of mpublic. Okay, let me compile. Everything is working fine. I am able to access mpublic. I'm able to set and get the value of mpublic. Okay, where is mpublic declared? Mpublic is declared in my base class. Where am I accessing it? I am accessing it in my derived class. So their derived class inherits from base class. What is the mode of inheritance? Now I am using this protected inheritance. All right, up till now all the inheritance that we saw, we use this keyword public, but in this example we are using this keyword protected. So how does that affect everything? Okay, I am able to access mpublic, fine, like before. I am unable to access mprivate. Let us try that. Like before, I will get an error. Yes, I cannot access mprivate. It is private. What about mprotected? I am able to access mprotected like before. Okay, so fine. So what difference does this make? The fact that I have changed this from public to protected, I do not see any difference up till now, right? So I was able to do all these things, whatever I was able to do, whatever restrictions that I had, it seems everything is same, right, up to this point. But you will see the difference here. When I had public inheritance, okay, and I had this derived class, and I tried to access mpublic equal to say 10, I'm accessing mpublic, I'm trying to access mprotected equal to 15. And I am trying to access m private equal to 20. Alright, all these three attributes are kind of there in my derived class. They were inherited from this base class. But private, of course, I will not be able to access anywhere, neither in my derived class or outside the class. Protected, I was unable to access outside the class, but I am able to access inside the class. Right. So public, I am able to access outside class or inside derived class. Okay, protected, I am able to access inside my class, in base class, and I will be able to access in derived class, the classes that inherits from base class. Okay, so these two places are where I can access this protected attribute. Inside base class, where the protected attribute is declared, and inside the class that inherits from this base class. Alright, and we are of course talking about public inheritance right now. So this keyword over here is public. And let me go ahead and compile this. Alright, I am getting mprivate is private within this context, so I cannot access that. Mprotected is protected within this context, so I cannot access that. So these two I cannot access even if my mode of inheritance is public. What about if I change it to protected? Okay, let me go ahead and compile. Now I have once again mprivate is private, so I cannot access that. Okay, mprotected is protected, so I cannot access that like before. Now there is something new. Mpublic is inaccessible within this context, so I cannot access mpublic as well. Previously, when I had public over here, okay, I was able to access mpublic. I was not able to access m protected or m private. Now when I change that to m protected, alright, I cannot access m public as well, right? So everything that I inherit from my base class cannot be accessed outside of the derived class. In my derived class, I can access both m protected and m public. M protected and m public, where are they declared? They are declared in base class. Where am I accessing them? I'm accessing them in derived class. What is the relation between base class and derived class? Derived class inherits from base class. What is the mode of inheritance? The mode of inheritance right now is protected. So what can I do in derived class? I can access public attribute of base class. I can access protected attribute of base class. I cannot access private attribute of base class. Okay. In my main function, is there any inheritance type relation between my main function and all this base class and derived class? No. Main function is independent. Okay. They are, it is not inheriting or doing any such kind of thing with anyone. So in my main function, can I create a object of this base class? Yes, I can. What are the data attributes that I can access? Data attribute or method, I can access only the public data attribute and methods. Okay, can I create a object of the derived class? Yes, I can. You can see on the screen. And what can I access? I can access, say there is some data attribute called derive and it is set to 40. Okay, I can access that. So yeah, this 40 I am able to print. I can access the public data attribute of derived class. Okay, I can access all these methods which are public in derived class in from this using this object that I created in my main function. What I cannot do is I cannot access this m private, m protected and m public which are inherited by this derived class from the base class. Okay, in my main function, all right. Why cannot I access this right now? Because my inheritance mode is protected. Had my inheritance mode been public, then I would be able to access M public. I will not be able to access M protected and M private. But because my mode inheritance mode is protected, I am unable to access any of them, right? So that is the problem that we have. Next is, so let's forget this. It's private, okay. So now my inheritance mode is private. Let me try to set public equal to x and return m public. All right, compile, everything works fine, everything is fine. I pressed something. What happened? Yeah. Oh, fine. So I'm able to access M public. Private, M private, I will not be able to access. Okay. And protected, I will be able to access. okay, m protected I am able to access, m public I am able to access, m private I am unable to access. So like before, okay. Now once again, if I try to access the three variable in main function, so m public, let me try to set it to 10, d dot m protected, let me try to set it to 10, and d dot m private, once again trying to set it to 10. Okay, I will not be able to set it to any of this number, so let me go ahead and try this. Okay, m private is private within this context, cannot use that. M protected is protected within this context, cannot use that. And m public is inaccessible within this context, so cannot use that. So now that I have my inheritance done using this private mode, I am unable to access any of these three data attributes that I inherited in my object, in my class, through this object, right? Through this D object that I created in my main function, I am unable to access any of these attributes. So this is what I have. So now you can once again ask me, what is the difference between public and protected in this, in that case? So we had the same problem, right? When we were talking about private and protected, when creating an object of the base class and trying to access these things, different data attribute from the base class, we were able to access m public, we were not able to access m protected and m private. So we were a bit confused about what is the use of protected, how do they differ. Now once again I see the same thing over here, right? In m private and m protected and m public, I can access the private and I can access the public and protected attributes of the base class in my derived class. Okay, in m public, in my main function, I can access m public in this public mode of inheritance. I can access m public. If I have the protected and private mode of inheritance, I cannot even access m public. Forget about accessing m protected and m private. I cannot access m protected and m private in my main function. Okay, but I can access m public in my main function if my mode of inheritance is public. If my mode of inheritance is protected, I cannot access any of them. So where is the difference between m protected and m private? Okay, the difference comes in further inheritance. So let us create one more derived class and let me call it D derived. So this is level 2, or let me call it L2 derived. So that means level 2 derived. Okay, and I am going to do public inheritance from derived class. Okay, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a function called set. Okay, let me just create set, otherwise it will be overriding. I don't want to override this, let it be. There is no reason why I'm not overriding this. If you want, you can go ahead and do it. It does not affect anything in this program. And it is going to take int x, int y, and int z. Alright, three different... What did I do? I don't need this. Sorry, three different parameters. This is int. Okay. So now let us create an object of L2 derived class, and this is of course going to be public. So let me go ahead and try to create an object, try to call this set function of L2 derived. So let me put 10, 15, 20. Alright, and let me try to compile this. So yeah, mPrivate is private within this context. So mPrivate I cannot access. Alright, and the reason should be very intuitive to you by now. mPrivate is declared as private, and I cannot access this private data attribute anywhere outside the class, right? So mPrivate is declared inside base class, so I can access mPrivate only inside base class, nowhere else, no question asked. So mPrivate I cannot access. Let this be. Let us not worry about this mPrivate anymore in today's class, because private I cannot access anyway. Okay, no point checking it over and over again. So this set is now going to take two attributes, two parameters, and this is what I have. Let me go ahead and compile this now, and yeah, it compiles properly. Let me have another function. If my program does not give any output, it does not look good. Okay, so this is what I have. I did not call this function. Yeah, so it's printing 10 and 50. I'm setting mPublic equal to 10 and mProtected equal to 15 in line number 33. Okay, and in 34 I am printing these two values, and those are printed into my console over here. All right so next let us do one thing. Let us try to access both mPublic and mProtected in my main function using this L2 derived class object. So d dot mPublic equal to say 30 and d dot m protected equal to say 40. Alright, so let me go ahead and try to compile this. I'm going to get an error. M protected is protected within this context. So m protected was protected, okay, originally in my base class m protected is written as protected. In my derived class mProtected I am able to access. In my level 2 derived class, which inherits in public mode from derived class, okay, mProtected is I am able to access. Okay, once again look at this. This is in public mode of inheritance. Okay, from my base class into my derived class I am using public inheritance. Alright, and from derived class to level 2 derived class, I am inheriting from derived class using public inheritance. I am not going to talk more about this level 2 inherits publicly from derived. Let this be. I am going to talk about the effect of this public inheritance. This derived class inherits from base class in public mode. This is what we are going to look at. Alright, so protected I am unable to access. Let me remove this. Public I am able to access. This should not be a problem. Okay, let me go ahead and compile, and yeah, everything works fine. Okay, so if I exchange these two line, I should get the effect in my output. Yeah, 30 and 15. M public is 30. M protected is 15. So protected, I cannot access in my main class and in my private, of course, I cannot access. And public, I can access in my main function. I said main class just now. Sorry. All right. Next, what I'm going to do is, I am going to change this public to protected. Okay, my I am deriving from base class using now protected. Previously I was doing this inheritance using public mode. Now I am doing this inheritance using protected mode. Okay, now here is something interesting that you can already see. I cannot access this M public as well. Okay, so let's remove that. Okay, everything is fine. What happens when I access M public? I am trying to access M public. It says M public is inaccessible. So if I do this inheritance in protected mode, then N public, I cannot even access using derived class had this been protected. So there is no question of having this as accessing it through level 2 derived class. If I cannot access it in my parent, then how can I access it in my child, right? So L2 derived is child of derived. So through derived class object, I was unable to access M public if my mode of inheritance was protected. So now in L2 also I cannot access it, right? So that is what I have. Now the thing is this, M public, when I inherit using this protected mode, okay, so M public also becomes protected. So I cannot access M public outside this main, in my main, outside my class hierarchy. I cannot access it. In main, I was unable to access it, right? But M public, I am able to access over here, L2 derived. All right, so this is what I have. So yeah, now let us look at this private inheritance. I will talk about this a bit more. Anyway, in the next class, I am going to come with pen and paper. Right now, I am just showing you the output of programs. In the next class, we will really deep down. We will dive down and talk about what is, how these are working behind the scene. Maybe in the next class or the class after that. Maybe in the next class, we will have another programming class where we will be looking at types of inheritance. After that, when I go to a theory class, we will be talking about this in greater details. Alright. So now I have changed the mode of inheritance. Okay. From protected to private. Now what happens? Okay. Both M public and M protected, I cannot access in my derived level 2 derived class as well. Forget about accessing it in main function. I cannot access it in main function. Okay. I cannot even access it in L2 derived. Alright. So this is what I have. This is what happens when I inherit, do this inheritance using private mode. So to recall, when I inherit using public mode, okay, in my derived class, what can I access? In my level 2 derived class, what can I access? And in my main function, what can I access? So if I inherit using public, then I can access I can access everything in my base class, right? This private, public, protected, whatever is created in my base class, I can access everything. In my derived class, I cannot access the private. I can access both protected and public. Okay, when my mode of inheritance is public, then in my level 2 derived class, okay, this public will be accessible as public, and protected will be accessible as protected. Okay, then what if I convert this to protected? In this case, this M public becomes protected, and M protected already is protected, so that stays protected. Okay, so what happens is that in my level 2 derived class, I am able to access M public and M protected. Okay, but I cannot access M private like before. And what about if I make this private? In that case, both this public and protected, M public and M protected, both of them become private. So I can access in my derived class, both of them become private. So I can access this M public and M protected in my derived class. These are private data attributes of derived class. I can access them, okay, but I cannot access M private. Okay, so this is what happens when I have this private mode of inheritance. Now this becomes private, right? I told you M public becomes private, M protected becomes private, M private not accessible. So M protected and M public becomes private. What does that mean? In my level 2 inheritance, okay, I can access none of them, right? Both M private is inaccessible anyway, but both M protected and M public becomes inaccessible in derived, becomes private in derived. So I cannot access them anywhere in this hierarchy of inheritance down the line, right? Like in my derived class, I cannot access M private. So in private mode of inheritance, M public and M protected becomes private in my derived class. So in my level 2 derived class, okay, in my level 2 derived class, I cannot access M protected and M public as well, because they become private in my derived class. Right? So this is what I have. So I hope you will go through these programs. You will write this program, experiment a lot, and see for yourself what happens when we do this. Okay, so yeah, write this program, go through this program. If you did not understand anything, just wait till you watch the video after the next video, where we will go through this theory of what is happening. So when I have a pen and paper, I will be able to explain this in a better way. I know you have some confusion. I was unable to explain everything properly because this is just a IDE in front of me, a C++ IDE Visual Studio in front of me, and there is no scope to draw and write things. So wait till that class. If you still don't understand, then you can of course reach out to me through WhatsApp, through mail, or by writing your doubts in the comment section below. Alright, so see you in the next video. Thank you for watching this video.